Solving the three main targets in autoimmune disease. Hi, I'm Dr. James Machino. You know, medical science has identified three main biological targets that are important in the management of autoimmune diseases. And those three targets are suppressing inflammatory hormones called eicosanoids, or prostaglandins. The second target is inhibiting the release of these certain cytokines from the immune cells that cause a lot of inflammation and causes cells to divide too quickly. And the third target is to better modulate or control the effects of how immune cells are working. So let's start with number one, suppressing inflammatory hormone production or these inflammatory eicosanoids. So here's how it works. When you eat foods that contain polyunsaturated fats, largely from certain vegetable oils, but other foods as well, they get stored in the body. You don't just burn those as calories. Some of them get stored in the body in your cells, and then they get converted by your cells into these little mini hormones called prostaglandins or eicosanoids. Well, some of the polyunsaturated fats get converted into really bad prostaglandins, like prostaglandin series 2, which promotes inflammation. So you don't want to eat foods that give you that type of polyunsaturated fats. So staying away from red meat and pork and lamb and duck and fried foods and trans fats is your best way to minimize your intake of the fats that will lead to those inflammatory prostaglandins. But some polyunsaturated fats produce prostaglandins that actually suppress inflammation. They make prostaglandin series 1 and series 3. That suppresses inflammation. That's going to be good for you. So that's when you have fish and when you have a supplement that contains fish oil, flaxseed oil, and borage seed oil each day, that helps to suppress inflammation by inhibiting the production of those prostaglandin hormones. Now, there are drugs that are anti-inflammatories that block the production of the pro-inflammatory prostaglandins, but those anti-inflammatory drugs come with side effects if you take too many of them. Ulceration of the intestinal tract, internal bleeding in the intestinal tract, liver damage, kidney failure, coronary heart disease or congestive heart failure and high blood pressure. And steroid drugs can do the same thing, some of the corticosteroid drugs. But they have effects like diabetes and osteoporosis and cancer risk and increased risk of infection and cataracts. So you can't depend on these things to a level that's going to get you into trouble with their side effects. Now, the second biological target, I said, was inhibiting the release of these inflammatory chemicals from immune cells called cytokines. So what happens in autoimmune disease is that one of the white blood cells in your body starts to act up in a really abnormal way. That white blood cell is called the macrophage. And the macrophage starts to secrete very excessive amounts of a chemical called TNF, or tumor necrosis factor alpha. The TNF then tells all the other cells to start secreting tons of inflammatory cytokines, which produce lots of inflammation and make the disease much worse, and they cause cells to divide too quickly. So people with rheumatoid arthritis start forming nodes and nodules around their joints. But it also causes fibrotic tissue to form in the lungs and in the kidneys, which can eventually shut down the lungs and the kidneys and lead to life-threatening consequences. So it's a serious problem. So there are drugs that inhibit the release of TNF, but those drugs, if you take them too often, come with side effects like an increased risk of cancer and opportunistic infection. So the good news is that there are some dietary and supplementation practices that can tone down the secretion of TNF from the macrophages and suppress this whole inflammatory cascade without side effects from the natural interventions. We'll talk about that in just a moment. The third biological target is controlling the immune cells and getting them to be normally regulated, or what we call bioregulation. In autoimmune disease, the immune system is hyperactive. It starts attacking its own healthy cells. You need to tone that down. And there are specific supplements in particular that can do that. We call that bioregulation. So the truth is that over and above medications for autoimmune disease, certain dietary practices and the right supplements are part of the comprehensive program because it can address these three biological targets without toxicity. The problem is that most medical doctors haven't studied a lot of nutrition and natural medicine, so they only prescribe drugs. But it's not good enough. The comprehensive program for autoimmune disease has to address all of these factors and include the diet and supplementation practices that have been proven to work. So I've written an article on this that you should review. Just click on the link below. You'll see it. It's called Nutrition and Supplementation Management in Autoimmune Disease. All the details are there. All the scientific references are there, so you'll know you're getting only sound scientific information from me on this subject. It's very important to read it if you have an autoimmune disease. Now at machinohealth.com, you'll see my other research, review articles, footage from my live professional seminars, other downloads, resources, videos that I have, all there to help you lead a long, healthy, functional life. All my review papers and teaching materials are complete with all the scientific references, so you'll know you're getting only sound scientific information from me on any topic that you're looking for. So you should make machinohealth.com an ongoing, reliable resource of health and wellness information for both you and your family members. Thanks so much for watching.